Hey, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Rechak, Wadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, and peace and salutations to the elect of the nation of Israel. Thinking here of after listening to Apostle Har's video that he did in transit today, I wanted to title this video, Don't Cool Off. Don't cool off. Don't cool down, man. You know what I'm saying? Continuing to have that fire that fire within us, man, is the most important thing going. Because after that fire goes out, talking about the desire. Salaki, talking about the desire to do this work. You know what I'm saying? And push the word in sincerity and in truth. It's pretty much game over. I want to get this priest up here, just like an impromptu. Let's see. There's a scripture, I can't find it right now. I'm driving right now, but there's a scripture that says, keep your lamps burning, And I know for a fact, Yahweh Shai said, let your light shine forth in the world, And that's a continual thing that we have to do. These scriptures apply as far as the commandments that we receive from Yahweh Shai, things of that nature, they apply to us now more than they ever have. And to let your foot off the gas, as brothers say, that's something that is not respected in the eyes of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, matter of fact, that's what I can get here in a second. Hold on, merge on the highway. Okay. All right. The scriptures say, through the terror of the Lord, we persuade men. Every time I hear Apostle Tahar speak about the destruction of Israelites who cool down, I get fearful, man. That reverence for Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, it kicks in, Damn, I'm trying to type and drive, so lock it. I just want to pull it real quick. All right, so this is 1 Corinthians chapter 5. I'm going to start at verse 9. It says, wherefore we labor, that whether present or absent, we may be accepted of him. Present, our physical bodies being present on this world, or our physical bodies being absent, or our souls, actually, Salakia. So it would actually be our souls being present in this world, or our souls being absent, being in the spirit world. So basically, we want to be accepted of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, whether we're alive or dead, so-called dead. Because when you die, your spirit goes back into the spirit world. Your spirit never dies. So if your spirit is absent from this earth, then you're considered to be dead. Okay? But whether we're dead or alive, we want to be accepted of the Heavenly Father. We're supposed to want this truth, and we're supposed to want to push this truth more than life. Okay? More than life itself. All right? Because the scriptures talk about that in Romans, the 8th chapter, how nothing can separate us from the love of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. Matter of fact, I read a scripture today at camp in Isaiah, the 50th chapter, that I actually wanted to go into a little bit farther. Make sure I'm going. Okay. 35. Okay, so let's get this in Isaiah chapter 50, and then we can go back. Right here. This is Isaiah chapter 50, verse 4. Yahweh, my power hath given me the tongue of the learned, that I should know how to speak a word in season to him that is weary. The Most High has given us this tongue. We haven't made our tongue to know these words. We haven't made ourselves to understand these scriptures. The Most High is the one who gave us the spirit to accept these scriptures, to accept the understanding that the apostles and elders have taught. Okay, and so being that the Most High has allowed us to understand these things, we should be grateful, and we show our gratitude by teaching what we learned, by doing what he commanded us to do, which is to teach what we have learned. And the easiest way to stay on fire for this truth is to continue to pray and fast, and to continue to stay in the scriptures, to continue to do your videos, you know, to continue to press towards that mark, you know. Continuing in verse 5, carrying on in verse 5, it says, Yahweh hath opened mine ear. Demons. Yahweh hath opened mine ear, and I was not rebellious, neither turned away back. That's the spirit. I didn't even know this was right here. Okay? The Most High have opened our ears to this truth, so that when we heard it, we received it, and we carry we let none of those words that we heard fall to the ground. Okay, meaning we don't let any of these words become idle words. Okay, all of these words that we hear are words. All of the words of the Most High that we hear, we carry them out to the best of our ability. Okay. And best of your ability means just that, man. All right, we're able to do a lot more than Satan wants us to think. All right. Continuing, I'm gonna read that, the middle of that verse again. It says, "Neither turned away back. I was not rebellious." Neither turned away back. All right, because the scriptures say, hey, if you turn back, your soul the scriptures say, if any man turn back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. Okay, talking about the Most High isn't gonna have pleasure in a man that turns his back on him. You know, Israel turned their back on the Most High, and that's why he disowned us as a nation. That's why he turned his back on us, because we turned our back on him first. The Most High is not gonna give up on you. Okay, if you give up on the Most High, that's when he forsakes you. All right, but as long as you continuing, man, that's the beautiful thing about this truth. That's the beautiful thing about this truth, man. As long as you continuing to push. And sincerity and you're doing your actual best, the Most High knows what you're capable of doing. He knows your limits. If you actively trying to push towards salvation, hey, that's the spirit, 441. I just passed exit 441, you know, which is 144 backwards, you know. As long as you're actively trying to push towards salvation, man, Most High ain't gonna quit on you, man. Okay? It says, verse 6, I gave my back to the smiters and my cheeks to them that plucked off the hair. I hid not my face from shame and spitting. We constantly get bashed by these people, man. By these scoffers and by these scorners and by our people, man. Just today at camp, there's a huge demon, man, coming up to the camp, talking all type of cash. You know, a woman void of understanding, of course, just going to show you, you know, and boost our faith that, hey, man, we're going to receive nothing but hell until Yahweh Shai comes back, which is part of the reason why we should continue to pray unto the Lord to bring Yahweh Shai and the angels, man. You know, one prayer that the elder Yatazak likes to push often, you know, in the Hebrew, I'm going to quote it here in the Hebrew, Shalach Yahweh Shai wa alahayim, you know, which in the English translated means send Yahweh Shai and the angels, because we know that when the Most High sends Yahweh Shai and the angels, that judgment that was prescribed upon Babylon the Great is going to be executed, you know. And when that happens, man, that means that the elect are soon to be delivered. And we know that we're in those times now due to all of the geopolitics and technology and false philosophies that have been spread upon the earth. Okay? But the more we pray and fast and ask Yahweh Bashim Yahshai to go forth with those things, the closer we are to those things actually happening. Okay? Continuing on, Isaiah chapter 50, verse 7. For Yahweh will help me. Therefore shall I not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be ashamed. So how are you going to not be ashamed if you're not preaching? How are you going to not be ashamed if you don't have that faith? Okay, to push. See what I'm saying? It's very important to have that faith to push and to have that fire, man. To have that fear. That fear that Yahweh Bashim Yahshai can take you out of this truth. He can take that knowledge, all of that knowledge, those hours that you put in, that you toiled, that you put in work for, man. The Most High can take that right up off you, man. And push you right back in that sunken place, you know. And then you're in a worse position as far as your destiny goes. You're in a worse position, man, than a regular two-third nigga, man. You know, because you fell out of the truth. That's the worst position you can be in. I want to go back to Corinthians chapter 5, and then finish up in Isaiah chapter 50. Man, these roads, man, these roads are demonic. All right, so 1 Corinthians, I'm sorry, it's like it. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 10. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of HaMashiach, that everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that he hath done, whether it be good or bad. Let's let that sink in. In layman's terms, everything that you do for this truth or so-called against this truth, because the scriptures say you cannot do anything against this truth but for the truth. But anything you do on this earth, whether it be good or whether it be bad, you are going to have to give account for it in the day of judgment, man. And we have to believe that. We have to believe that, man. That has to be our bread and butter. We let that truth of the scriptures fight for us. Because if that is true, then that means the only thing that we have to do is to continue to fight and believe in the name of Yahweh Bashim Yahushua. Continue to push that name and exalt that name. Because through that name, we receive salvation. Through that name, we receive redemption. You see? That should want you to continue to fight. You know what I'm saying? We should have in our mind, and I'm going to say it, man. We should have in our mindset, because we know that we're not going to be here forever. But we should have in our mindset, man, to continue to fight and push the word if we're here for another 100 years, man. Okay? Like I said, we know we're not going to be here for another 100 years. Esau's infrastructure won't be able to last that long. Okay? That's not the point that I'm trying to make. The point that I'm trying to make is, look, man, the apostles and elders have been pushing this word for going on 30 years, man, if not 30 years already. And they still on fire, man. Okay? They came into the truth as young men. Teenagers, man. Early 20s. All right? These men are old enough to be some of them my grandfather, man. Okay? My father, at least according to the flesh, and they're still pushing, man. We have excellent examples through the spirit, which gives us no reason to feel any need to take our foot off the gas spiritually when it comes to pushing this word, when it comes to being a brother, when it comes to applying this knowledge. Okay? We have no excuse. You see? No reason to cool down. No reason to take time off. Yahusha didn't take time off. You see? As soon as he was able, he was dwelling in the temples, learning. You see? The more locked in we stay, and the sooner we get fully persuaded in our own minds and the spirit, the sooner we'll get delivered, man. The more videos we put out, the longer we stay in the spirit, the longer we fast, the more charitable we are, the sooner the Most High is going to send Yahushua to come redeem his elect. You see? These are words of encouragement. All right? Let me get a couple more scriptures and we can close out. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 11. Knowing therefore the terror of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, we persuade men. Apostle Har persuades me personally to do the work. Because now I understand the terror of the Lord. I hear the precepts of, if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. I remember the precepts of thou wicked and slothful servant. You know, thou shouldest given my money to the exchangers, to where I could get my investment with usury. Roughly paraphrasing. All right. I've heard the precept, and I've been explaining the precept concerning if you crucify Yahawashi again afresh, or take your hand off the plow, man, then you're in a worse condition than a man who never heard this truth. And that strikes fear in my heart, man. You know? That causes me to want to do more for Yahawashi Yahawashi. That causes me to be sorrowful and remorseful, man, and make me want to repent, and make me want to bring fruit, meat for repentance, which is continuing in this work. You see? Because Yahawashi Yahawashi is our witness, man. He's the one who counts to see if you're in the spirit, you know, and see if you read, and see if you being brotherly. You see what I'm saying? He's the one that weighs the spirits. So the word is getting pushed out. You see? That's what the goal is to do. Continue to push out this word and do the work, because you show your faith by your works. Continuing in verse 11. But we are made manifest unto the Most High, and I trust also are made manifest in your consciences. So we are showing our works to the Most High, and He is testifying. All right, the Holy Spirit is testifying, man. He's our witness. The Holy Spirit is our witness. The Most High is our witness. Okay, and also that also too, we pray that those who hear our words we pray that those who hear our words receive our words, okay, in their consciences, all right, or in their minds. I'm going to go back to Isaiah chapter 50. All right, continue in Isaiah chapter 50, verse 7. I'm sorry, verse 8. He is near that justifieth me. Who will contend with me? Let us stand together. Who is mine adversary? Let him come near to me. Behold, Yahweh, my power, will help me. Who is he that shall condemn me? Lo, they all shall wax old as a garment. The moth shall eat them up. Okay? Our enemies, man, they're going to be destroyed. We have no reason to fear the enemy. So to make that an excuse in your mind is unacceptable. You know? We're supposed to want to continue in this work, man, and boldly profess the names of Yahawashi Yahawashi. Okay? We should fear Yahawashi Yahawashi and respect Yahawashi Yahawashi enough not to quit on him. Because he ain't going to quit on us. All right? Hey, Lord willing, this is edifying. With that, I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashim Yahawashi, Ba'ashim Rechak Wadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, and peace and salutations to the elect of the nation of Israel.